basically what you're gonna have to do is make a very strong tea out of the herb of your choice. Hi guys, and welcome back on my channel. My name is Wana, and today I'm gonna share with you two ways to make herbal hair rinses at home. I'm gonna start by telling you that 6 months ago, I cried one night when I noticed that my hair lining was thinning and it was like going back at the back of my head, and I was losing hair massively. It happened after I gave birth to my second son, and everybody was telling me, relax, it's gonna grow back. Well, from my experience with my first pregnancy, when I started losing hair, it never grew back. It was just thinner and thinner. So right now I panicked. I panicked because every time I was taking a shower, every time I was combing my hair, I was losing a handful of hair. I started noticing the empty bald spots, especially here in front. So I freaked out. I started doing some research, and I wanted to try something natural instead of turning towards the products that you can buy on over the counter in the pharmacies, because I wanted something natural and I wanted something easy to make, easy to use at home, and let's be honest, I wanted something very affordable. And when I started noticing that my hair is growing, I actually have baby hair growing. I never thought that this is gonna happen. Now let me come a little closer because I want to show you the baby hair. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it, but it's everywhere here in front, and only the short one, and it's going everywhere from here to here. All this part that in the beginning I was losing hair, now it has baby hair growing back. This is, to me, this is amazing. It's fantastic, and I felt so much hope. And I decided to make this video because I know there's a lot of people struggling with hair loss, and I'm thinking maybe you haven't tried this method, maybe you haven't tried these herbal rinses at home that you can make at home, and this is why I'm gonna make this video, and I'm gonna ask you to please share it with everybody so we can help as many people as possible. Depending on the herbs that you decide to use, you can help your hair grow faster. You can relieve like other scalp conditions like dry and itchy scalp and dandruff. So herbs are really important. We just need to learn how to use them properly. You can use either dry or fresh herbs. It's fine, whatever you decide. The one thing that you have to keep in mind is that if you decide to use dry herbs, they're more strong, they're more potent than the fresh ones, so you have to use less amount of those. The first ingredient that you're gonna need is apple cider vinegar, and I'm very excited when I say apple cider vinegar because this ingredient is very, very important, and it does have a strong smell. So what I'm doing is I always take a shower and I rinse my hair at night. This way, my hair has plenty of time to air overnight, and in the morning, the smell is not that strong anymore, and during the day, it disappears completely. So if you don't like the smell of vinegar, please try to wash your hair at nighttime, and you will see that the smell is gone in the next day. I really love apple cider vinegar because it cleans the scalp and it removes any residue left in your hair. Also, it helps detangle your hair, which is gonna make it less breakable when you comb your hair, and also makes the hair soft and shiny. So what's not to love about it, right? And another ingredient is gonna be wherever plant, whatever herb you choose. There's so many out there that are beneficial for hair and hair growth, and the ones that I really love are rosemary. Rosemary helps improve circulation to the scalp, so definitely helps with hair growth. I think rosemary is to blame for my baby hair right here, and to actually see my hair starting to grow back. I really love it. I definitely recommend you to try it. And another herb is sage. Sage is great if you have any scalp condition like dandruff, like a dry and itchy scalp. You should definitely try the sage vinegar infusion. Just be very careful with one thing, because sage darkens hair color. So if you're a blonde and if you don't want to change or darken your hair color, you should use chamomile instead. Use chamomile tea, because this will help your hair, and actually it will help the highlights in your hair. It will enhance them. Or if you decide to use sage, because it also has very good properties, just like I said before, with dandruff, it helps you get rid of dandruff, dry and itchy scalp. So if this is what you're trying to get rid of and you want to use sage, just make sure you're using it not that often and just mix it with something else. Another herb that I really love and I definitely recommend you to try it is horsetail. Horsetail helps your hair grow strong and less breakable. This, combined with the rosemary that helps your hair grow, imagine that. Your hair is going to be growing faster, stronger, and it's not going to break that easy. This is great. I really love horsetail. Another herb that I love to use is thyme. Thyme helps you with so many other scalp conditions and also helps you if you have oily hair. There's so many herbs out there. Just try and do your research. You can use calendula, you can use, I said chamomile, you can use peppermint, you can use lavender, you can use so many of them, and each of them are helping our hair to grow, and it's also, they're helping our scalp to get rid of everything that it bothers us. If you decide to use lavender, then make sure you're using at nighttime, because lavender also has aromatherapy, relaxing properties, and you know, it will help you definitely sleep better. I'm trying to think, because there's so many of them, and each one of them are doing something amazing that we don't even realize what they can do for us. Now that we talked about the herbs that you can use, we're gonna make a concentrate vinegar herbal rinse. Now what I like to use is a rosemary infused vinegar and a sage infused vinegar. You can mix and use them together, or you can alternate between them and use them on their own. All you need to do is place your herbs in a glass jar and fill it up with raw apple cider vinegar. Now make sure that the herbs are fully covered. Then you just let your herbal vinegar sit for at least 2 weeks. Once it's ready to use, just add a few tablespoons in a bowl and dilute it with water. I keep my jars with herbal vinegar in the fridge to keep them fresh. And this way I make sure that they stay good for a very long time. And as a plus, you can use this herbal vinegar as a dressing for salads. It's very convenient and delicious. If you really, really hate the smell of vinegar, or for some other reason you don't want to give it a try to something that smells like vinegar, I have another recipe for you. And all you have to do is use really hot water instead of vinegar. But what you have to keep in mind is the fact that this is not a concentrate. This is a quick use, and this is a one-time use. So basically what you're gonna have to do is make a very strong tea out of the herb of your choice. All you have to do is pouring boiling water over a handful of herbs. Practically, just like I said, you will do a very strong tea. Now let the herbs in the hot water for at least 20 to 30 minutes. Now when it reaches room temperature, make sure it's not hot, dry it first. Take the herbs out and use the infused water to rinse your hair. Remember, when you use the vinegar herbal concentration, remember to dilute it with water. Now, what I do for my hair, which I think it's a medium, right? I think it's a medium size, my hair. I like to use around 4 tablespoons of vinegar concentrate, and I dilute it with warm water while I'm in the shower. If you have shorter hair, shorter than mine, then I would suggest for you to use between 2 and 3 tablespoons of herbal vinegar concentrate. And don't forget to dilute it with water. And if your hair is longer than mine, then you can easily use between 5 and 6 tablespoons of concentration. This is just a suggestion, and you can feel free to use as much or as little as you want, or as much as your hair needs it. I promise you that you will feel the difference. You will start seeing the difference if you're gonna use it constantly every time you're taking a shower. Now, let me tell you when and how I use my herbal vinegar concentrate. I wash my hair normally with shampoo, and because I don't use conditioner, I jump straight to use 4 tablespoons of herbal vinegar concentration. If you do use conditioner, then wash your hair normally, shampoo, rinse, conditioner, rinse, and then as a final step, use the herbal vinegar concentration. Because this is the last step that you will do, and don't forget to close your eyes when you pour this concentration, because vinegar can sting your eyes. I definitely start seeing results. Not only that, my baby hair start growing, but I saw that my hair is more soft, and I swear to you guys, it grew much faster. So I can remember when was the last time when I had a haircut, but it was really short. I think it was up to here to the earlobe. And now look at it, how much it grew. It grows fast, and I don't know if it's that strong yet, but probably I would need like at least a year of using the herbal vinegar infusions to have a strong hair. I'm not scared anymore, because I can definitely see an improvement in my hairline, and I know my hair start growing, and I know that I'm doing such a good thing for me, for my body, and for my hair. If you know someone who is fighting and having problem, they're struggling with hair loss, then please share this video and make sure it reaches them, because all they have to do is give it a try to this natural remedies, and it's so easy and they work so fast and they're so good. So if we can help someone, then please share this video. Feel free to share this video. If you like my video, remember to give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please click that subscribe button. It means the world to me. And guys, until I see you next time, kisses.